IDS, which stands for Intrusion Detection System, is a system designed to detect intrusion attempts. The goal is to identify potentially malicious traffic, such as intrusion attempts, viral attacks, and unusual outgoing traffic. In summary, an IDS detects suspicious activity based on a standard. If activities deviate from the norm, the IDS issues an alert. IDS records and reports identified issues to help understand threats and enhance global security. The IDS achieves this objective by monitoring the activities of a target, which can be a network or host machines. Depending on the target, there are two types of IDS. The first is the network IDS, which monitors the security state of the network. It is located on an isolated network and analyzes a copy of the network traffic between its entry points and network terminals. When a threat is detected, network IDS can raise alerts. It is entirely passive and cannot communicate with the monitored network. Next, there are host IDS. It monitors the security state of hosts based on various criteria, including machine activity, for example, the number and list of processes, number of users or consumed resources, and user activity on the machine, for example, connection times and duration, commands used or activated programs. Host IDS also analyzes potential activity related to the actions of malwares such as worms, viruses, or trojans. Now let's move on to IPS, for Intrusion Prevention System. Unlike IDS, IPS is positioned in line, meaning it does not analyze a copy of the data, but examines the data itself. IPS operates in real time to actively prevent identified threats. Unlike IDS, which primarily alerts, IPS reacts in real time by stopping recognized suspicious traffic, especially by blocking ports. Moreover, IPS dynamically enforces security policies based on real-time analysis. There are two main types of IPS. The role of a network IPS is to detect attacks on a network based on an attack signature database, similar to antivirus software. When it recognizes a signature, it can take measures to block the attack before it starts by blocking the malicious flow. Host IPS monitors the security state of host machines. It does this by monitoring various elements of the machine, such as processes, drivers, and DLLs. If a suspicious process is detected, host IPS can stop it to end the attack. Popular security solutions often include both IDS and IPS features, such as Cisco Firepower, Palo Alto Networks, Fortinet FortiGate, and open-source tools like Snort and Suricata. Lastly, it's important to clarify the difference between a firewall and a network IPS. The role of a network IPS is to detect attacks on a network based on an attack signature database and to block them if necessary. The role of a firewall is different as it aims to control access by defining authorized or prohibited communications. For example, outgoing direct accesses in HTTP to the internet are prohibited. These flows must pass through the company's proxy before going outside. However, modern firewalls may include IPS functions, leading to confusion, but they are in fact complementary functions. Note that I have a dedicated video on firewalls if you want to learn more. To stay in the loop with all things tech and computer science, be sure to click that subscribe button and ring that notification bell. See you soon.